I'm just gonna take this piece off, cut the hole out for the speed tie, and cut this speed tie hole out as well. So I'm gonna use just a regular box cutter for that. They already have the lines perforated for you here. You can either do it from the inside or you can do it from the outside. The only downside to doing it from the outside is if you slip with your knife, you're gonna put little cuts in the plastic, and that's gonna be visible. As if you did it on the back, it wouldn't be visible if you mess up. Okay, so like I said before, you can do this from the back. Obviously, this one is easier. You really can't do the front one from the back, unless you have, like, I don't know, noodle arms, because it's up in there, so that one you're just gonna have to be careful with from the front. But if you just basically take your razor blade and push in, I mean, along kind of a straight line, you're not really gonna mess it up because these holes are already like there for you. So it's fairly easy to cut them out. Just be careful with the razor blade. So when you're done cutting it out, I would just go around the edges and with your razor blade and just clean it up a bit so it doesn't look so grubby and unfinished. But when you pop it out, this is what pops out. You're just gonna throw that away. And then I'm gonna do the same thing up on this one. Like I said, you're gonna have to do this one from the front because unless you have noodle arms to get it back here, that's not happening. Again, on the front, I would go around with your razor blade and clean up the edges. Be careful on the front one because it's much thinner plastic than the back, so it doesn't take much force to get these out. And again, just throw that in the garbage. So for the back speed tie, you're gonna wanna mount it to this plate. You have to pull it apart. The one piece goes in front. The big piece sits on the back of the plate.
Make sure these are up so that that's the right direction.
So right now he's putting these longer bolts on with one of these bars here, with a small washer, as you can see that he already has on there. Those are a 10 on the front. So before you mount the whole thing, you want to put that trim piece on, this guy here, so you don't have to take it off and put it back on, like so. Don't forget it.
Mounting it to the bottom of the handhold, make sure you put the big washers on top. Helps spread the load out on the plastic. And then a small washer and lock nut on the bottom.
So the front speed tie is gonna mount up here. You see all those little posts? With the front facing that way. And you gotta move this hose out of the way to be able to get to it. And then when we put it all back together, this hose isn't gonna be able to sit there, obviously, because the speed tie is gonna be there. So you just have to like push it in to make it fit. So that bar mounts like that in the middle and up. So the 90 degree angle goes to this side. Hey, what's going on? What are you doing?
Getting the speed tie ready to put in.
Okay.
Put the plastic piece on.
Put the plastic piece on first, people.
Yep, and then test fit it. Make sure it's the right direction.
Don't forget it.
All right. Front speed tie's held on by these self-tapping bolts and these little tiny washers.
So the longer bolts go on the front piece. Right. Oh God, where's my finger? Yeah, right there.
The cage bars previously installed.
So we're gonna mount this one up in front. So he's gonna put two screws in just to hold it. And then we're gonna put the bar across because it's kind of a pain to line it all up without something holding it. So this one's pretty hard because you kind of have to just work with your hands without seeing it. So to take the handlebars off and switch those, there's two 10 millimeter bolts here. We gotta pop this off. You gotta take these covers off. And then the levers are plugged into wires. So you gotta take those off and then just snake them back down through because they obviously come out right here. And then this whole thing, just pull it straight up and it will come out. So to take these off was the screw on the top and the T30 on the bottom. Up and back. Fight with it for a second till it pops out. You're gonna take these out, which are super tiny. I don't remember what size they are. I will tell you in a minute when I get there. It literally just slides off. Also, this slides off. Pro tip, plug these back in before you mount it to the new handlebars because it's a pain in the ass to try to plug those in if you already have it mounted to your new handlebars. So the screws that we just took out of here, you don't need those anymore. We unplugged these. You could loosen this, lift it up, and unplug it to make it easier, but we could not figure out what size these were. So they are a 7/32 apparently, which is super tiny, and they're held in by like nothing, so when you go to tighten them, don't over tighten them because they will just start spinning. So there's a zip tie back here that you gotta cut to let these wires fall through. So now that we have everything off, yep, just pull it straight up and the whole thing will come off. So in the instructions, it says something about a magnet being on the back of these. I'm thinking that's gonna be for the 16 and olders because the 18 and 19 did not have them on there. So don't fret, it's not a thing you have to worry about. Okay, so I'm gonna use some blue grease on here. You're gonna take this piece. It is like separated, so it's not broken, don't worry. I'm gonna put some grease around the outside of this, and then I'm gonna put some grease down here. It's just what the factory one had. And obviously to turn your bars, you don't want it to be sticking. So that's what we're gonna do now, and then we're gonna set this right in. So we just set that in. The collar that you put on there, the teeth go down. All right, so now we got your handlebars, you got your clamps, and you got your four bolts. We're gonna put them up there, and they obviously go on here. And make sure you keep alternating which bolts you're tightening down, because if you tighten one too much, then the other one's too loose, and yeah. So the handlebar bolts are a 13. Zach got me there, so yeah. Occasionally works on BRP stuff, yeah. Doesn't do it as a career or anything.
Definitely not.
So to put these pieces on, they actually bolt right to the bar, these three pieces here. See this little nub right there? That goes in the middle hole. Just like that, and it basically holds it there for you. And then in your bag you have a couple of these little guys, and they go right in there. So we are going to transfer these grips over to the new bars. So it's a T30 in the end. Just zip those out and then the grip pulls right off. But to put these grips back on, there are these little gold washer things in here. So I can get it out. They look like this. You're going to take it on the bar. Put that bottom piece right in that hole. And then when you put your grip on, if you look inside, see how that has a U? You want to match it up with the end of the bar so it seats right in there. And you might have to tap on it a little bit to get them all the way on. And then you're gonna use the last long bolts right here to screw them in. Put these in, make sure you put the washer on before you zip them in there. And that's approximately the angle that they're supposed to be at. This slightly up. So now we're gonna do the wiring for the VTS system. So what I did was I folded this guy in thirds, because it says if you're doing the handlebar risers, you need to cut most of the protective sleeve off. So approximately like a third of it stays on. And then you have to snake it through here and just make sure you go the right way. So all your handlebar connectors are here. And then we have to snake it through this one that goes to your gauge cluster to plug it in. So because you have to feed it through all these things and to eliminate it getting caught on stuff, what we did was we'll stagger these and tape them so they don't get stuck, and so you don't have a big clump trying to go through. And then we'll tape it at different intervals through here to snake it through. Unplug both of these, the one to the DESS and the gauge cluster, so you have this whole thing free to work with. 1, 5, and 6, the top ones basically. We're gonna pull those out and shove those guys in. To get the little nubbies off on the back, you have to pop this out like that. And then you should be able to take those out on the back. the tool down the front of it. Should be able to get the pins out of the back. Position one is the black and white wire. You insert it with the little tab down. The next one is position five, and it's the blue and white wire. And then the last one is the white and green, and that's position six. And make sure you put them in far enough to hear that click. Beautiful. So after you get that all plugged back in up there, you're gonna take this harness, you're gonna put it through this hole. It doesn't snake up the center anymore. It goes back here. Probably getting grease all over my arm. And then they're gonna come up the back here, and you're gonna zip tie them to this post here. They're gonna go up. You're gonna go up and around, and then into the housings. Make sure when you put this all back together that you route this big cable over top of this. So then when you have your handlebars at the full upright position, all your wires will actually reach. All right, so if you put your riser in the upright position, you're gonna run these wires in front of the bar, and then they're gonna snake back here and into the housing. You got your VTS, your start button, and your reverse over here on this side, and then your throttle on the other side. And you can tell that this is the reverse one because these are right together. So if you want to make these look a little nicer, you can get this tubing stuff here, just so your wires aren't exposed like that, which doesn't look very nice. Over here, your VTS sits in this little spot here, and then your start button has a little spot down here for it to sit in. And then we're gonna put the cover back on. Are you helping? Are you helping?
No.
You helping? You might be named after a lion, but you're not a lion. No biting.
And as far as I can see, I just need privacy. Plus a whole lot of tree, fuck all this modesty. I just need space to do me, get a world what they're trying to see. A Stella Maxwell right beside of me. A Ferrari, I'm buying three. A closet of Saint Laurent, get what I want when I want. Cause this hunger is driving me, yeah. I just need to be alone. I just need to be at home.